So we have just seen ASML's stock price drop by 16% on the back of disappointing forecast. And while that result has shaken the whole market, it looks like the same can't be said of all the chip makers. And so in this video, I'll be sharing with you three top semiconductor stocks that have strong buy ratings for you to have on your watch list. And so with your time being very valuable, here are the top three stocks which we'll be talking about today. First off being Taiwan Semiconductors, next being Qualcomm Inc, and finally Broadcom. So if you're new to the channel, please drop a like and hit the subscribe button so you never miss out on any of the exciting content which we've got lined up ahead. And let me know what top stocks are on your watch list and what you'd like to see more of in the comment sections below. And by the way, this video is not financial advice, and so I strongly encourage you to do your own due diligence and make your own decisions which match your investment needs. And so with that out of the way, let's get straight into it and talk about our first investment case here for Taiwan Semiconductors, which is now sitting at $187 per share with a market cap of $821 billion. And on a year-to-date basis, they are sitting up by a staggering 84%. And over the last 12 months period, even better at 105%. We know that there are certainly fears of inflation with the market correction forecasted, but the data we are seeing here shows that the AI train is not ready to be slowed down anytime soon. So if you're sitting there thinking you've missed out on this run, you certainly need to think again. So here's what you need to know about Taiwan Semiconductors. Where Taiwan Semiconductor is a multinational semiconductor contract manufacturing and design company. And they are the world's second most valuable semiconductor company, the world's largest dedicated independent semiconductor foundry, and its country's largest company. And TSM specializes in fabrication operations rather than research and design of new and innovative chips, which means that they command lower margins than some of the most flashier semiconductor stocks out there. But since many leading fundamentally fabless, meaning they have no manufacturing capacity of their own, there is built-in business for TSM every year as they are contracted to turn designs into real hardware. And based on their operating model, there is possibly no company more tied into the broader industry, so it's no surprise that whilst their revenue slumped in 2023, they are on track for a 22% rebound in 2024. They announced their net revenue for September of 2024 with third quarter sales hitting $23.5 billion, which surpassed the company's predicted sales range of between $22.4 billion to $23.2 billion by $300 million, which was on the high end of guidance. And on a year-to-date basis, their net sales skyrocketed by 39.6%, which was the fastest rate since July of 2024. And TSM here has seen robust demand from big customers in the AI market, mainly NVIDIA and Apple, which resulted in an acceleration of their net sales in the month of September. And I feel this clearly indicates that the momentum is not waning, and TSM therefore has a very solid chance to impress investors with their third quarter earnings in the coming weeks and quarters. And one analyst noted that Taiwan Semiconductor is still dirt cheap for an AI stock. And they said that the challenges facing Intel and Samsung has strengthened TSM's status as a preferred AI foundry. And TSM's ability to deliver the much-needed AI chips for NVIDIA and AMD is critical to sustaining its high-capacity utilization and tech roadmap. And another analyst noted that Taiwan Semiconductor is one of the best and cheapest AI plays. They said they are the cheapest generative AI play as one of the trifecta of AI godfathers alongside NVIDIA and ASML. And with the foundry already reporting robust preliminary third-quarter results, they believe that it is well positioned to report a double beat and raise performance on the October earnings call. So combined with the extremely rich balance sheet and geographically diversified production capability from 2025 onwards, it may undoubtedly remain a core holding in most discerning investors' portfolio. So clearly one to watch and not snooze on just yet. Next up is Qualcomm, which is currently sitting at $174 per share with a market cap of $193 billion. Qualcomm is up 24% on a year-to-date basis, and over the last 12 months, up by 57%. But Qualcomm so far has had mixed fortunes throughout the year, having reached highs of $230 midway through the year, only to give up most of those gains following some disappointing results. But the good news is that that has provided plenty of entry opportunities for those who see value. And if their outlook is anything to go by, then some really exciting times lie ahead, and it appears the takeoff is round the corner. Qualcomm was founded in 1985 by a bunch of super smart engineers led by Irwin Jacobs. and they had a vision for a future where people connected and communicated through handheld devices, and now Qualcomm sits at the heart of the technologies of the phones we use today. And the name Qualcomm is short for Quality Communications, and the company has pioneered the cutting-edge chip technology that allows phones to connect with towers over radio frequency. Their technology has allowed 3 and 4G and is currently supporting the 5G build-out. Their proven solutions drive transformations across major industries, and their Snapdragon-branded platforms power extraordinary customer experiences. Speaking of fabless chip makers, Qualcomm predominantly relies on third parties to produce its best-in-class semiconductor products for wireless communications. And that includes a key design for Apple, including chips that provide 5G connectivity for iPhones. But I believe there is a risk with this model, as the loss of the big contract with Apple could result in significant reduction of their footprint, which is worth bearing in mind. And one analyst predicts that Qualcomm is set for a 50% surge in their Snapdragon 8 Gen 4 shipments by late 2024. And they say the company is poised to benefit from better than expected momentum in the fourth quarter of 2024 and favorable trends in 2025, including AI smartphone, AI PC growth, and increased system-on-chip prices due to the adoption of TSMC's 3-nanometer process. And according to the analyst, amongst Qualcomm's mobile system-on-chips this year, the most expensive and profitable Snapdragon 8 Gen 4 will see most of its 2024 shipments in the fourth quarter of 2024, so clearly one to keep an eye on. And finally, our last on the list, which is Broadcom, which we spoke about a few weeks ago when it was sitting at $145 per share, and goodness me, have they been adding value as they now sit at $175 per share with a market cap of $821 billion. And this takes their last 12 months' returns to over 94%. And what's even better is that there is still plenty more room to grow to hit that $1 trillion mark, going by their outlook and wider sector demands. So clearly another one not to snooze on. But here's their latest. Broadcom has been getting loads of positive headlines, with Goldman Sachs calling them amongst the best two phase 2 AI stocks. And there are also lots of question marks around whether Broadcom could become a $1 trillion stock by 2025. But here's a summary of their story again for you and why that may be the case. Broadcom is an interesting mashup of entities that have been acquired at various times since the company went public as AVGO Technologies in 2009. And whilst M&A is not an exact science and many companies struggle on their execution, Broadcom has been highly successful in targeting and integrating accretive acquisitions. And after establishing these businesses as cash cows and taking a pause for a few years following the purchase of Symantec in 2019, Broadcom once again pulled the trigger on a mega merger with VMware last year for $69 billion. And overlapping with this acquisition, the AI wave took the market by storm, benefiting Broadcom due to their wide array of product offerings that enable AI infrastructure buildouts. And this has created a sort of super cycle for operating results, where VMware is contributing to higher consolidated financials, while the growth in AI is spurring organic growth in tandem. And so if you're wondering where the 100% stock price appreciation over the last 12 months have come from, I think this combination is an obvious culprit. What I found most impressive was how well Broadcom has been able to maintain extremely attractive margins, even whilst ramping spending for AI demand and at the same time absorbing VMware's operations. And before the VMware acquisition, the company reported net profit margins of 51.7%, and in Q3 of 2024, that number was at 46.8%. So whilst this may seem like a significant drop-off, when you consider the costs associated with a $69 billion merger and the associated pitfalls, then maintaining this level of profit margin is further evidence of Broadcom's operational excellence in my view. And in that vein, the integration of VMware led to an explosion in software infrastructure revenue from $2 billion all the way up to $5.8 billion, and at a 90% gross margin for the segment. And the speed at which Broadcom has gotten this acquisition up and running internally and generating a profit and cash flow should have investors optimistic about the future of this combined entity. So clearly an opportunity for you to keep an eye on. So here you go with three solid semiconductor stocks for you to consider for your watch list. What do you think? Please let me know your thoughts on these three stocks in the comment sections below. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope you found the content useful. And if you're new to the channel, please make sure you subscribe and hit the bell so you never miss out on any of the new releases on the channel.